mamá de huevos. Vete, ay.
Wait, that's not a joke.
Welcome everyone to my anime, the second ever event, and it's going to be huge. Now, for those of you who don't know, this match just got added a few days ago at the Rebellion. Postponed their match for the World Warrior Cup. And no,
and no, introducing Spencer Nightfall.
Nightfall looks confused. I don't know if this is the Fallen's doing or not. But right now we have a World Cup match. Rebellion postponed it. And we have so much more to watch on this show. We'll get into this a little bit. I don't know if Lee Nice is going to make it here in time. But these two have been forced to team up. They don't rival us for weeks, months. Forced them to do a tag team entrance and all. Thank you, Pepsi Man, for finding the song. These two still look like they're not on the same page. But if they want to move on in the prestigious World Warrior Cup, they will have to get along. They do not have a choice otherwise. Wait! Where's Nuvom? Nuvom Complex just took a shot.
All right.
And Nightfall. The bow keeper trying to just keep Nuvom away. What the actual? Match beginning. When it moves on to the second round of round cup. Winner of Mafia moves on. Ooh, and Solitaire has been eliminated. Now with Lee Nice choking out. Can these two move on? Not really on the same page here. We have so much more on this show though. Right after this match, I will be going to go do live refereeing, special guest referee for Spencer Nightfall's match against the Fallen. Soul versus Chance of a Lifetime Big Slam to Nightfall. Also, on the night, just name it saying, and Jake Matthews, bitter enemies from NEW, face off for the World Hardcore Championship after months of fighting off Lee Nice and Bobby J. Ooh, using the jacket, stunning him. If Lee Nice can even be found after months, they go one on one for the Aztec Championship. Brother versus brother. Quinn Chandler versus Brandon Chandler on the card in a rematch. And speaking of brother versus brother.
Two.
Oh, wait, this could be it.
Two.
Jester versus Kato. Kareel versus Kareel at Kato's 12th. Wherever that is. Going to tag in Lee Nice, but he's not there. We'll also see now updated Elise versus Rocky Jackson with the winner getting an Intercontinental title match against Storm after
out of the corner. Constant. Tag.
Whoa. Not really on the same page with that tag. Two. After Constant N made a claim that Elise never lost the title by pinfall. Ooh, big shot to the face. Choking up, and the sibling rivalry continues.
Tag.
Spade as the creature takes on Rick Silver in Extreme Mayhem match for the BYW Championship and arguing on the outside. Come on! Ooh, big shot to the head! Lindsay Gowie stunning him! And Demon Slayer Navin going to the corner. This may have just turned to one-on-one. I don't think Demon Slayer is going to be going for the tag. And then that will go fly like a bellow.
One, two, two.
New bomb still in this. This may have been
going
to a bit of a one-on-one match. New bomb may not like Demon Slayer, but sure as hell he wants the Road Warrior Cup. And of course, Spencer Nightfall may not have Leonidas. Ooh, we've all seen unique pickup slam down. Devon arguing again. But you may not have Leonidas. But we know one of the best tag teams in WWE history are gonna keep fighting to get that World Cup on the checklist. Ooh! For the Rebellion's Special on his own! But that ain't enough for Nightfall! He hits us on the falling!
One, two, over. Three! Your winner!
Rebellion move on!
Spencer Nightfall! Cup.
And to the surprise of no one, Demon Slayer just let it happen. What a way to start off the show. We start out with a handicap match. Quickly going to one-on-one. We seem to get on the same page eventually. I have to go rough a match. Needs to leave the damn arena.
Oh my god!
Oh,
Sane! Are you good? Are you okay? Do you need help?
You should really take this reminder.
It looks like your world title match is canceled!
Yeah, I'll send him these later. He really needs some CDs.
Send me those as well.
Got you.
Hey, quality memory.
GM, he defines his title whenever he wants, wherever he wants. We welcome you to your next matchup with the most on the line, introducing the Fallen. Only way to win this match is by taking the skull and on the line. If the Fallen can win, they get a chance of a lifetime. But if Spencer Nightfall loses, his soul belongs to the Fallen. We'll see if the Reaper rests tonight, approaching Halloween. This match all begun. Spencer Nightfall has had a very much disagreement with me in the coming weeks. He kept taking the careers of the people I care about. But now it's time to have something taken from him. Can he beat the Fallen? looks like Halloween is in full gear here tonight. Your living nightmare may just become the Fallen's nightmare if you can somehow win tonight. And I have even added the stipulation, if the Spencer Nightfall can somehow win, he also gets a chance of a lifetime. I'm playing it fair. No cheating here tonight. This man gets all the chance to win. He is your NEW Tag Team Champion, your living nightmare, Spencer Nightfall! And I am your special. Guess what? I am keeping it fair. Trust me. You guys ready? Your soul's on the line. Ring the bell! This is walking up. Much similar to a flag match, they retrieve the skull. Any way they do so is legal. They can go into the shed. They can climb a ladder. No disqualifications until then. Big elbows to the fall. Ooh, big kick straight to the face. Nightfall is charging up. And that's just why it's gotta be played fair. There is no fast count that can go in this matchup. Ooh, right over the knee. There is no pinfalls in this matchup, actually. Did I clarify the rules with you? I said I was gonna play it fair, but I probably forgot to say that. No pinfalls in this matchup. I should say that, Cody. You gotta get the skull to win. Chance of a lifetime on the line. I can only imagine what the Fallen wants with it. Remember, me and the Fallen do not get along. But we came to an agreement. The Fallen, I wouldn't even say is doing my bidding. The Fallen is simply greedy. The Fallen is evil and doing what he pleases. And I almost regret giving him a chance of a lifetime on the line. But remember, I played it fair. To get it, he must win this match. And Fallen, taking his time, methodically kicking Nightfall straight in the face, taking it to the outside. The shame from the Fallen on display. What does the Fallen have in mind? Ooh, head first into the turnbuckle. Very different getting a live view of this commentary. And I'm gonna get a live view of this right here, right now. Picking up Spencer Nightfall. Oh, but Nightfall picking up the Fallen! Oh, breaking the Fallen through the wall, breaking it in half. Fallen in a bad, bad way right now. Can you hear the wood still cracking? Ooh! Kick straight to the face! Using the broken wood as a weapon. Ooh! You can hear that snap, that bend. Nightfall is on another level. So much on the line here tonight. Ooh! That's gonna affect Fallen's ability to grab the skull in the future. This match, Nightfall, vicious. Nightfall has become a master of targeting limbs in the past few. Ooh, crushing the hand in the past few months. Talking about last year, was very good at methodically attacking the leg and knee. Ooh. And that's one of the things about Spencer Nightfall. In a moment's instant, he can get fast. He's vicious. He's methodical. And I've said a million times, the pitbull like offense unmatched. And in a match type where there is no rules, it might favor him, but remember, the Fallen is, Fallen's a Reaper, known for being evil. Landing a bad way, there is no give. Ladder going into the face. Cameraman coming to get a better view of the action right here tonight. This isn't gonna be the faint of heart. And the ladder's set up. Anything goes in this matchup. And we're about to see if Spencer Knifehart's body can go through anything to save his career. Another falling with a ladder. Climbing one rung at a time. Very close. Gonna need to get a little bit higher up. The fallen may have just won this match. Oh dear God. Bad positioning. Fallen. Torture rack. Ooh, straight onto the knee. Oh dear God. The fallen may have just been knocked out. One of the most vicious strikers in BYWE, and now making it back. I was about to say making it back in the ring, but Knifehart clearly has something else in mind. Looking for something. Oh no. I'm gonna feel bad for the fallen. You hear that second smack? That's because Knifehart is swinging so far back, it's hitting the damn rope and now burning the arm in a bad way. Ooh, now finding the body back. This may not be able to win the match, but it will do damage in the fall one to make the fallen not be able to grab the rope. Ooh, hitting on to the candlestick and into the mat. Very smart to make sure the fallen does not be able to use the arm. Ooh, crushing the hand. Ooh, that's not pretty. This match will be played fair. Down the middle. Going for a powerbomb. Ooh, crushing the fallen. Knifehart now climbing up. The fallen has a weapon. Oh, straight across the back. Writhing in pain. We talked about the viciousness of Knifehart. Let's talk about the viciousness of this man. Fallen has torn on every single portion he knows. And now, oh, is looking to torn Knifehart's leg into two, trying to break it in half. Approaching down the ladder, looks like Fallen had something else in mind. Oh, getting the big one. Full speed ahead. Oh. Something sadistic on the mind of the fallen. Fallen and Knifehart have both competed in multiple ladder matches, but this could be one of the last matches involving ladders that Knifehart competes in if he cannot win here tonight. Grabbing my leg. Knifehart can barely stand at this point. Ooh. We still are taking it to the absolute limit. And I think we know what the fallen has in mind. Oh, Knifehart trying to just get away. Oh, a vicious sleeper hold. And that's why I call pitbull-like offense. It's vicious, it's not pretty, but it's effective. Oh no. Ooh, torture rack, rib breaker, and now going. Oh dear God. Taking himself out to put maximum punishment onto the pond! This shows how much Nightfall is willing to fight! And that's why I put the bonus of the chance to last him! But Nightfall may be a bit screwed right here, but he can't get the ladder out! Well, I think Nightfall is gonna have to be a bit creative here to get them out! Fine getting out, but did Nightfall take up too much time just leaning it against the wall? Nightfall's down! Nightfall has it in his hand! Ooh, I'm falling down to break it up! Nightfall's still going for it! The tenacity in Nightfall is admirable, though I don't always agree with him. He's willing to fight! We're falling, but I'll do maximum damage! More fireman's carry! Again, taking himself out to put maximum damage! I think Fallen hit a bit of the metal underside of the ring. Pointing his own neck, hitting the ladder to put maximum damage. This could be it. Nightfall soul could be long to the Fallen. Oh! So Fallen getting up 6 feet under off the damn ladder. I think Fallen wants to get his own money. Ooh! Dodging! Fallen holding his own head. Oh! Into the... Oh no! Oh! Into the shed, now into the ring! Nightfall! Calling void! Oh, dear God! Spiking the Fallen on his head! Oh! I've said it throughout this match and I'll say it again. If Nightfall was just any type of person, other than he is, the tenacity that he has would be admirable. Nightfall, what does he have in mind? Collecting the furniture from the outside. Okay, Nightfall. Looking to get the bigger piece of wood, do the most damage he can do. Oh, the Fallen's up! Ooh! The Nightfall's gonna keep fighting! Not gonna let the mind games work! Pile almost crushing under the weight of the Fallen.
Does this company have any good chairs?
You know what? Maybe with the rest of us don't break each chair so much, we would have more chairs. Doing what you need to do. Ooh, now that's what I call a DDT. And that ball going to the far corner.
Like I said, I'm your living nightmare.
Going for Nightmare! Oh! He's forced into the wood! Now Fallen clearing a path. Oh no, no! Crushing the head of Nightfall! Now the same from the fallen picking up Nightfall with the slightest of ease. Oh, strongest slam onto the tail. Going up now. Fallen might just win this matchup. Has it in hand? What's Nightfall going for? The Fallen's not ending the match? Fallen could have had this one! Oh! Fallen could have almost had this one! Not Nightfall! The adrenaline! He's up! Smack him on his face! Fallen is stunned! Oh! And use that chair as a weapon, breaking the back and neck. Nightfall, the tenacity, the strength, doing it again. Fallen bending in an unpleasant way. Making a bit of a pile. Now this might be Nightfall's match to win. Barely standing. Nightfall has the ladder. He's going to climb, save his soul, and own himself a chance of a lifetime. This could be all she wants. Oh no. Reaper's Call! Using his powers, Fallen has won the match. Yes, retrieve the skull. Hey, cut the music. Good job, Fallen. You have earned yourself a chance of a lifetime, but listen, I was actually just trying to teach Spence and Nightfall a lesson. You don't need to take his soul. Music. Bobby J, thank you for doing music. You can go. Oh! Oh.
I got you, brother.
This match is for the Aztec title. And introducing first, the Alpha and your NEW Tag Team Champion, Leonidas.
I forgot to say, your future Aztec champion. The Alpha has you lied. And I was just told,
yes.
Coming back.
It's time to fill these shoulders with gold.
Into the commentary booth. From Uncle Ed and from Rozo, I cannot believe
And introducing
this.
Your BYWE Aztec Champion, Bobby J.
A little early on the introduction there, Rocky, but I cannot believe Rocco's Mafia has attacked Justin Everson, Phoenix Lee, the Hardcore Chinaman. For tonight, we've been really enjoying it. I'm so glad Lee and I got back there in time to enjoy that. But listen, I am actually genuinely hoping that Nightfall is okay. I 100% did not want his soul taken. Whatever is wrong with the Fallen is absolutely disgusting. You did not need to try to take the sword out of the car. They have puppets for Bobby J. But I think after everything, I can finally say
this match is for the Aztec Championship. Leonidas, are you ready?
Yeah.
Bobby J, are you ready? Ring the bell!
I can say after.
Look pretty naked without your three reasons.
Oh, don't worry. That's gonna become a reason why I'm better than you soon enough.
I can say though, after that tag team title match and what happened to Nightfall, I can say I think I'm done with the whole revenge for them. And I can just focus on watching these matches. Ooh, up and over. Particular tag team match and Bobby mocking the reason why being gone. Because due to a
winner-take-all match featuring
one, Bobby J,
two,
the Mountain Man were able to take the tag team titles, but we were in Anarchy Jackson. Anarchy Jackson will be in action later tonight.
Come on, one, two, three, four, come on.
If Leonidas gets disqualified, he does not get the title. Similar though, if Bobby gets himself disqualified, not only will he lose the match, but then if dodging, the Aztec title will actually become vacant. Sonic Album. Now going after the arm. For that new finisher we saw, they effectively used only
Leonidas. Do you submit?
Among others, Bobby, a fighting champion, I would love to see him win. He's been doing a lot of open challenges. Letting a lot of people get matches, get opportunities. He's a true fighting champion. Though unfortunately, Leonidas simply does not give a fuck about the competition. You know, I think many of those matches attacking Bobby J. Or attacking his opponent. Though, due to Bobby J not intentionally getting disqualified, Bobby was thankfully able to keep the Aztec title. We're always seeing this match, those rules with the Aztec title may come into play. Leonidas is already bending the rules. If he breaks them, he will lose the match, and that's not something he can do if he does win the Aztec title. Again, going after the arm, now holding the rope to his legs. If Leonidas was to win the Aztec championship, he will have to follow the rules, and that's something that much fits the MO of Bobby J.
Come on.
Ooh, unique! Ankle breaker! The Aztec champion is about being a warrior, or being a fighter. The former Street Fighter body fits that MO. And yes, Phil Alpha, one of the best wrestlers on this roster. Former world champion, multi-time tag team champion, United States champion. He 100% is a fighter. But there is times he simply breaks the rules and does not care about the match.
Three.
He cares only about winning. In the Aztec title, though, there is no champion advantage.
Safer end zone.
Ooh. But that's what I'm talking about. The skills of Leonidas.
You go that way. Let's drive it there.
Even when I absolutely hated him.
Go. Home run.
It's hard to deny that he is talented. He has the cat-like reflexes, the pure wrestling ability.
Two.
Sometimes it's hard to match Leonidas. A mix of strength and speed, but the flying of Leonidas cost him. And this is one of the things though. We've seen some good technical ability from Leonidas, Bobby J.
Come on, the artist, do you submit?
Really nice. Tap out. And go back. Over the line. Lee has a title. Lee Nice saying no. Ooh, what a big knee. Now vicious stomp and kind of go. Terrible one again. Effective this time. But not enough to get the pin. But this is why Lee Nice is one of the most sought after wrestlers in BYWE. One of the first wrestlers to go to any has fought at the now former BWO. Bobby trying to get out of it. Lee Nice though, strength. Not gonna let it happen. Trying to hold onto the rope. Ooh! Unpleasant landing for Bobby. Now submission of his own. Will Bobby tap up?
Come on, Bobby, do you submit?
Now back to the arm. Straight to the elbow. Very smart.
Leonidas, do you submit?
Very smart. Doing damage to both arms. I'm trying to make him pass out. But that almost trapped himself into a pinfall situation. Lee Nice almost took the Aztec Championship.
Get away. Get away.
Lining him up. Ooh. Straight to the anchor. Faking out a super kick. Now to the knee.
In doubt, go for the bad knee.
Ooh! RJ has a history of leg injuries. About this time, a year
Bobby,
ago.
Bobby, do you submit?
That knee injury cost him the Intercontinental
Championship.
Come
on, Bobby, do you submit?
Come on, Bobby!
Against Spencer Nightfall, Leonidas taunting Bobby. He's been alive as... Still fighting, though. The fight from Bobby J is admirable.
Come on, Bobby,
do you submit? Come on! Holding
come on! Give me a...
Not letting go. Bobby almost...
You on top!
Bobby almost got out of it. Leonidas almost let go. Now flipping it over. Almost.
Leonidas, do you submit?
Bending the arm and leg in a bad way.
Come on.
There's that cockiness. That drive. Of being the best,
you
can see on the face of Lee Nice. Don't lift the leg again. A year ago, that knee injury prevented Bobby Gay from actually wrestling at the first My Enemy event.
Come on, off the rope.
Now down to the power into his own leg. Bobby is effectively put his arm and leg on Lee Nice. But Lee Nice is going to keep fighting. Go, boys! Suplex Falcon! Arrow! Let's go!
One, two!
Bobby ain't giving up yet. Bobby, falling into it.
No!
Submit to all the blood!
Leonidas, do you submit?
Will Leonidas tap out? He tapped out before. And now switching it into an ankle lock.
Leonidas, do you submit?
Has the damage to his body been too much? Trying to don't use the shield's weapon! Almost caught them now! Gotta lock back into the submission! And he does! Pulling it up though!
One! Two!
Not enough! And now, trying to get him! Are you stunned? Oh! Picking him up! Getting out of it though! The knee injury is too much for Bobby!
Let go!
Now that's like a pig stabbing into your back.
My title!
All of Rome right on the head! Here we go up. Yeah, I said not today. We have a new ass champion. Yes,
three.
We do.
Your winner and new BYWE Aztec champion, the Alpha Leonidas.
After so many tries, after months, Leonidas is finally your Aztec champion.
All worth it in the end. It's all worth it. Cause now, your Alpha is the champion you all deserve!
I know Prince Chandler's here somewhere. He keeps running from me. He's scared of me. I'm a fighter. Who are you facing?
I'm either facing Darren or Elise at the next pay-per-view. And it doesn't matter who I face at the next pay-per-view because I'm walking out either way as the BYWE Unified Champion.
Prince Chandler keeps running because he thinks that he won because of Doomsday. But that's not how it went. That wasn't sanctioned. And when I get my hands on him, he will know who the real heir to the throne is. And that's gonna be me.
I cannot believe Warcross Mafia tonight. Jake Matthews and Prince both taking out their opponents tonight. They have won by forfeit. Matthews gets to keep his World Hardcore Championship. But this is not where this ends. I will solve this all very, very soon. I just hope to God Blue Spade does not take out Rey of Silver before the huge main event matchup. But remember, we still have more on the card. We heard King Storm talk about his Unified Intercontinental Championship, which the number contenders match will be later in the night. We still have a huge matchup right after this at Kato's Turf, Creel versus Creel. And next month, you will see Forever Damned, the new November show. And it is going to be one to watch. And I think I'm starting to have a certain plan of what I think would be the big match on that show. And I think Warcross Mafia may not be liking that too much. We move on to the Creel versus Creel matchup. I know what a lot of you are saying. This does not look like the BYWE, and that is because Kato challenged Justin to go to his this year, but much like Mike Myers, Jester has been fortunately unstoppable. But will tonight be Halloween kills or Halloween ends for Jester, as he now is risking everything to take on his own brother?
The Max has come off darkness. You can see Justo looking around, trying to find where Cato is. You can barely see the surrounding. I think that's a farm vehicle. Cato clapping the distance. See a flashing light. It looks like Cato is going to use his surroundings to his advantage tonight. Justo still trying to find Cato. What's going to happen here? Oh, there's Cato! Ooh, making a quick attack! We gotta get this camera in focus! Ooh! Straight into the corn! Now remember, unlike a regular match, you have to remember, every slam, every time you fall down is going to hurt even worse. That's pure ground. No protection. Now using the corn as a weapon, choking the life. Barely have time to take off jacket, just trying to get it off. Ooh, using it as a distraction, but not gonna work. This is Kato's turf. Kato has the advantage. DDT straight onto the damn ground. Trying to choke out with another stalk of corn.
Your career's over tonight.
Dang, his career is over. We mumble. By the end of this match, there is only one winner. Only one career remains in Kato. With a simple statement, Evil dies tonight. Kato looks to end the reign of Twisted Jester, but where did Kato go? Oh! Using his surroundings again as his advantage. The Death Knight, the Scarecrow, the Psychopath Killer, again into the darkness. Stalking him. Oh! Like these damn children of the corn! And again, there goes Cato into the darkness. Just waiting. Where did he go? Forging himself a weapon! Just waited and stalked for the simplest of sounds to get Cato. I'm trying to drag him out of the corn maze. Remember, if Cato passes out, if he goes to sleep, his career is over. Is that a rock? Straight to the back of the head. This takes a sibling rivalry to another level. Just about this time a year ago. Up onto the shoulders. Straight onto the pumpkin. About this time a year ago, the fourth match in BYWE, Cato versus Twisted Jester. These two would then face off exactly a couple years ago. Facing off for the then fourth champion, BYWE, the Intercontinental Championship, where Jester will lay Cato into a casket. And now, a year ago at the force of a My Enemy event. Climbing up onto the tractor. Right onto the wheel. Not the highest you can go, but still flying! Taking him off his feet. From a year ago, they have weapons to match for the World Hardcore Championship.
In my territory now.
Throwing seeds at the face. No glove. These two will face off at the first My Enemy event. At the force of a Mother Madness match, Jester would also win.
Cato, can you breathe? Can you keep going?
To make sure Cato can damn breathe inside the pumpkin. These two have teamed up. They have been enemies. They've been friends. Tonight, it all comes to a definitive ending. Oh, this is gonna be an unpleasant landing. Crushing his back.
One, two.
Look at the bun. To just get a pinfall, cracking the pumpkin. Very unpleasant. Ooh! A corpse stomp, something that Kato has felt many a times in the past from his own brother. And you can see Kato barely moving. This is it.
One, two!
Guys, put away two. Kato, but it's not pulling him away tonight! The forced rivalry in BYWE coming to a close. And this is not gonna be pretty. He's saying jerk or cheat, but we know this is all trick, all action here tonight. Ooh, getting out of it. Ooh. Kato getting back into it, getting the advantage. And into the corner they go. Oh no.
Ooh. One! Two!
What a slam. Well, you saw Kato pull one of the rocks out earlier. That's cool, hard ground with rocks, with corn stalks. Almost like a whip effect with those leaps. Just a taking it to Kato in his own turf. Kato's still fighting.
One, two.
Hitting Kato in the back of the head. Kato took too much time thinking about what just happened. Thought he had it in the bag. Kato forced to his feet. Just to take a moment to breathe. And Kato capitalizing. Again, going into the darkness. Just rising. Where the hell is Kato coming from, taking himself out, using himself as a weapon? You know these two are gonna fight. If it was on their careers, on the line or not, these two absolutely have hated each other. Again, Kato is gone. Ooh. Did he just throw a damn pumpkin at the head of Twisted Chester? That's
one,
it! That's a damn concussion!
Two!
That's a damn concussion!
One.
You hold out hard those pumpkins.
Nobody cares about your career.
They were barely breaking under their own body.
Two!
Gotta roll him up!
One! Two!
And it hit just as straight in the head. Look at him trying to shake it off. Kato trying to take a moment to recover. Trying to get some distance, possibly hide in the darkness again. But they have taken out more than
homies!
Leaving Kato with not much places to hide. I think Kato thought he would have won by now. Taking out most of his cone maze. Ooh! Taking it to a new part.
How's the barbed wire feel?
Going back, ooh. To the tractor, to that booklet. Just do it. Taking time to recover. Wait. What the? Kato is damn on top.
Come and get me. Come on.
Look how far away he is from the ground.
Come on, Chester.
The tire you're is about the fights. Same height of Twisted Chester who's trying to climb.
What are you gonna do?
Wait. Chester. Getting in. Playing possum. Kato does not know where he went. Which side is he gonna come out of? Kato is trying to find him. Ooh. Chester's tactic almost worked. Kato.
Come on.
Yes. Good job, Kato. Dude.
Get up here and fight me like a man.
Do not jump off that. Keep tricking Chester for going up. Ooh. Remember that steel?
He wants to
under
Chester.
His arm. Very smart tactics to get. Ooh. Hard landing from a far distance to get Chester. Damage. Now going down. Yes, Kato. Go down. No. No. Don't do this. Don't jump off that. There's hard rock below!
One! Two! Two!
Taking himself out! How did Chester kick out? What on God's green off? Both put. Both staggered, both can barely walk, and the match still isn't over. Ooh, curb stomp. And another
trick
pumped in.
Bitch.
Ooh. Taking
I choose treat.
Ooh! Using the seeds as a weapon. It may have just
you want to make
it may have just distracted him, but done this enough to get him into advantage. Trying to submit Twisted Chester. Shovel now in hand. Jabbing it into the back.
Just to do one some match! Any time now, Chester! You can quit!
Would Chester quit? Giving up his own career!
Do you want some it?
Throwing down the shovel. That ain't gonna work. And in to the darkness again. Kato keeps trying to get the advantage on Chester, changing the terrain into unknown places, leaving Chester confused and then attacking him when the moment is right. Chester spotting him though. Ooh, off the hay bale, but catching him. Not working that time. Crushing that thick hay bale.
One, two.
Picking him up. Powerbomb.
Do you want some, Kato?
will be KO. Hushimet gives up his own career. Rubbing hate into the eye. Kind of blind. Kato. Kato. No.
One.
No. It just gets to three. Kato's done.
Two.
No. No. Oh. Barely.
They hit the goal. Kato's doing it.
Barely in it. Kato still fighting. Still in this matchup. Now it's just who's controlling the pace, controlling the situation, taking it into a... Is that a bond? Ooh. Damn, looks like a scene out of Texas Chainsaw. Is that a pitchfork? Kato trying to put an end to Jessen and was doing almost everything to do so. Trying to stab, twisted Jester. He's trying to get some space to breathe.
No.
Doesn't matter which domain you're in. I am the fifth goddamn Rifflinor.
No.
Ooh, now Jester taking it to Kato. Slamming it around like it's a pinball game. Saying it is his domain, but it is his dark carnival no matter where he goes. Kato trying to gain some space, just to pull him back.
Submit, Kato.
Just a talking to himself. He has something in mind.
You got some nice, fun toys here in your little domain.
Just as clearly seeing something he likes.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Dragon Kid. No, that's not just a monster. That's a damn rat trap.
This is gonna be fun.
Look how thick that is.
No.
That could break his fingers. Kato's thankfully getting out of it. Jester's whip. Now doubling it up for extra damage. Looks like Jester came a bit prepared.
Let's try this again, Kato.
Fuck you.
Spitting in the damn face, the disrespect, the moxie.
Fuck you.
Kato getting up is going to use that piece of wood as a weapon. The moment of hesitation, seeing his brother gets up, and Kato is back into it. Grabbing him by the damn ears for that neck breaker. Playing field has been even. Just using the walls to get up. Kato is trying to drag himself away, get a distance to get some rest, but just is back on the attack.
Yo.
Ooh. Slamming his ankle onto the ground.
Yeah.
Putting it in between a piece of wood and that pallet.
No, come.
Don't do this, Jetta. Don't do this. Ooh. Crushing his ankle. Ooh. You can hear that sap from Tennessee. Damn, the people back at the arena could hear it. Again, just trying to get some separation, get some rest, but he can barely stand. His leg, too much damage.
Come prepared.
Now the barbed wire bat.
Come on, we're brothers.
I don't give a shit if you're family or not.
Straight to the arm. God.
All I care about is torturing and winning world titles.
Trying to grab it from his hand. Trying to stay in the fight. Bailey has one arm and is losing a little bit. That bat's getting close. Mikado getting up. Trying to fight. Ooh.
You're not shit.
Heavy shot to Jester. Now beating the living hell out of his brother. Those shots getting harder and harder. I think there's blood spewing. Gila's shots sounding a bit different.
You're not shit.
Yeah. He just bloody and beat his brother. Blood everywhere from the heads of Jester. Barely moving. Oh God, I can barely see with that light. And after everything that Justice went through tonight, like a pumpkin straight to the head, those heavy shots busting him open. I think Justice can barely see a little bit. Stumbling around, he's trying to find his footing. Getting a bit closer now, I can get a bit of a clearer view.
Nothing you can do when you can't see.
Kato truly has been prepared all night. Come on.
Gash.
Now we're back to where Jester was to begin the match. Northern Lights! That's it! Now making sure he puts his brother down. Frog splash! That's it. His career is over.
One, two! Just a two count.
How? How was that just a two count? How is Jester in this? How is Kato in this? We're in the fall late game of this matchup. These two are bloody. They're barely standing and now choking the life out of Kato. Spear! A classic from these two's moveset. There's no chance. This is over.
One, two, two count.
What? Are you serious? What lengths these two are willing to go to save their career? Just to barely moving. And found another weapon, or as he says, toy to use. But he's barely standing. Kato barely breathing. Long is back with the wake. Straight to the stomach.
You can give up, Kale.
This counts. You can submit to this. Give his career up.
Give up.
Straight into the throat.
You want to quit?
Another sleepover type of glide. We saw Kale almost pass the lawyer tonight. With the thumb to the eye. This is it. Kale is barely in this. I'm surprised he's not coughing up his own blood.
Submit.
Kale, barely moving. Barely in this. Come on.
Kale.
Come on, Kale.
You wanna quit?
He's trying to feel where Jester is, but hand going down, he's fading. There we go. He's still in this. Kido's still fighting. Trying to even it out. Gets him. Oh, separation, and he did. Heavy shot to the jaw. Kato's barely breathing though. Jester barely moving. This could be either person's game in this matchup. Kato just crawling. Trying to get to his feet. Jester still crawling. Who will get to the feet first? Jester just trying to make the catch up. Get his brother. Save his own career. Using the truck tire to get and stay on his feet. Heavy shot. Now, what does he have in mind? Oh, we saw him use this recently. Can he lock it in?
Kale.
Can he lock the straitjacket in? And behind it. It says he's behind it. Knee to the back.
It's in.
It is in. Will he submit? Give up his own queer.
Kale, do you quit?
No. I'm sorry, Byree. I failed you.
No. No, come on, Kale. Fading. Kato's fading fast.
Kato. One.
No.
Two. Three. That's it. Wing them up.
Goodbye.
You win on this match. Twisted. Jester.
Jester wins. Kato's career is over.
The last remaining Deathbringer. You are not making it to the main. Your dog bar tonight is gonna be same one as always. You just talk too much sometimes. You will be seeing me tonight.
Wolkos Mafia keeps attacking their opponents, but Silver is not letting Spade get out of that easily.
For the Unified Continental Champion. And to this in first.
Spade, we're happy to find the world title against Silver. But speaking of champions, Rocky Jackson expected to be getting an Intercontinental Championship match. Though, after Constantine and Fagan put question of him being number contender's ship,
his opponent, Ali,
and putting Ali's forward of deserving it more, stating that Ali's never got a rematch. In this match forward, winner faces Kane Storm for the Unified Championship.
Are you two ready?
Ring the bell.
Rocky, pissed off. First time over these two, we'll go one on one though. Ooh, around this time, locking up. So far, very even. Around this time, I see they have a big tag team feud. Ooh, big one you got. Revolving around Constant and the Fallen and the Control Bloodwood Cord. Getting out of the way fast. Though the question still remains, who has been attacking Elise? Constant figuring, we're trying to figure it out. We still do not know. Getting out of it. After all of these months, we're changing to an ankle line now, going for a submission. Elise trying to find it. Conan go over. And now has it locked in. But it's been going on since August and we still have no clue. And part of the reason of the attack is why Elise never got a chance to go after the title, leaving Rocky Jackson open to keep attacking Storm. But it is a fair thing that they were saying. Ooh, cat trying to catch the foot. Rocky Jackson though, getting enough of the kick. Lining up now. Ooh, straight to the knee. Quick movement. Eye on the target into a DDT. This is Elise's fourth match since losing the championship. But they've been making a fair statement and they even made more after Prestige went off the air. That Rocky Jackson never owned a match. Rocky Jackson just attacked Storm numerous times. Doing it out of greed. Though, Rocky Jackson also made fair claims that he almost won the Unified Battle Royal, where Elise lost the United States title, then getting unified with the Intercontinental. So both making claims, so we're gonna equal it out. Who gets it? Ooh, big shot. Rocky trying to get her to come closer. Egging on the black with big clothesline. Full speed ahead. Rocky trying to go for the maximum damage. Trying to go for the mountain man suplex. Elise getting out of it. Rocky Doke, he's gonna keep fighting. Spinning into a neck breaker. Very smart, Rocky. He ain't gonna get her up. Switch it into a neck breaker. And now, looking for the exclamation point, the cutter. Lining it up. Getting out of it. Very smart, pulling Rocky away from the ropes. Elise, a bit tired. First match in a month. Remember, she was supposed to have other matches this month, but kept getting attacked. Ooh, into a stunner! Getting away to catch his breath. Elise, stunned. Stalemate this fall. Ooh, mixing the clothesline. Ooh, boots straight to the ribs. Now Rocky looking to catch his breath. Does not want to mess up this opportunity. This is for a unified championship match. Rocky Jackson knows how much this means. He's a former Intercontinental champion himself. Elise, though, held the United States title. Never held the Intercontinental. Ooh! Trying to go for a spear. At least catching though. But not trying to go for a slam. At least no fighting. Switch into an armbar. Ooh, now bending the shoulder and arm in a bad way. Rocky Jackson. Ooh. Got to hold the United States title before it went away. Now going for the finisher. Rocky Jackson was fighting too much though. Couldn't lock it in fully. Decided to slam on the back. And again, another smart move. We saw Rocky Jackson, when he couldn't hit the move early in the match, went for something else. Elise doing the same. Both have yet to hit their finishes. Each other have gotten out of it each time. Elise, though, has fought Aki for the Intercontinental title. Ooh! Big clothesline. Ooh. Stomping away now. Could Elise get one step closer to winning? Ooh. Her fourth Intercontinental title. A former tag team champion. Ooh. Catching Rocky Jackson. Rocky Jackson, as I said, knows what it's been to be an Intercontinental champion. Breaking the hold. I think what pisses off Elise the most, though, is the fact that if she stayed longer in the match, we won't have the Intercontinental title. We would actually have the United States Championship. Remember, in that match, only one title was going to remain. Only one got to stay, putting feeling back into the knee. King Storm decided to keep the Intercontinental title, unifying the United States inside of it. Stalemate though. Locking up. Who will get the advantage? Pushing away. Ooh, big shot. Trading blows now. Barely able to stand. Using the ropes to keep on her feet. Ooh, big knee to the gut. Now going for a DDT. Moment of night is still not over. After this match, we still have a big Extreme Mayhem match. And this match could be moment away. Rocky Jackson going for the title. Lining it up. No, out of the way. Dragging from the ropes now. And now going for the Black Cauldron. Rocky trying to fight. Hit. Face straight onto the knee. Could that be it? This finisher, she can hit it. It's where one of the United States title could take a one step closer to the Intercontinental Championship. Trying to take him down to the knee. Ooh, getting the separation. Both exhausted after this match. He's making the first move. And if this can hit, that'll be all she wrote. Knee straight onto the back. Has it? There is no kicking out.
One, two, three.
Your new contender. Facing King Storm soon. Taking back the championship. Proving she owned it all along. And proving she's a rightful contender. What a show we've had tonight. But it all comes to a close in a Mayhem match for the BYOB World Championship. We'll see Sibling versus Sibling. And it's off and on rule. You can all bow down. The last time we faced off one-on-one in a special event was at the fourth Bloody Valentine Painkiller versus Rhea Silver.
I end the creature tonight
in the force of a CT street fight where Rhea Silver won. Their force BYW Championship. But tonight, for the first time ever, Rhea Silver faces off against the creature. Bruce Spade said, "You will bring the monster." This has been problems going on for about a year now.
This match is an extreme mayhem for the BYWE World Championship. In this corner, the challenger, Diamond Rhea Silver. In this corner, the champion, the creature, Blue Spade. Are you two ready? Ring the bell.
Immediately going after the creature. Straight on the attack, knowing what the creature's all about. An unstoppable monster. Slick move by Rhea Silver. Jumping back into the ring and immediately into his shoulder. Straight into the gut. Charging up, big kick straight to the face. Ooh, me taking Silver off their feet and ripping off the knee pad, slapping it to the face. Ooh! Unpleasant! Silver motivated by getting rid of the creature. But creature just motivated by holding Rhea. Silver does not care about anything but keeping the World Championship. And I can't even say, as usual, it's about the creature being extra monstrous. Blue Spade in the past few months has just been an undoubtable asshole. Doing anything to keep the championship. Full speed ahead with a double splash. Now leading by the arm. Pulled back. Clothesline. But what happened a year ago? These two were tag team partners. Well, about this time, Blue Spade was secretly forming the Wolf Horse Mafia and would use the creature as an excuse of attacking Solitaire, saying he couldn't control the creature. He was behind the attack. Oh, wrong! Charging up to hit that trail, getting a little bit more speed, a little bit more velocity, lining up with a Sybil! Kicking it! Sybil, not gonna give up. One of the biggest fighters this company has. One of the biggest hearts in this company. And of course, a former World Hardcore Champion. So they know their way with a chair. Bulldog flapping the face. That could have broken the damn nose. But the creature is hard to stay down. Ooh, over the rainbow. The creature is still standing. Charging up now, using the kill with leverage. Ooh, straight into the gut. And that's what Silver's been talking about. Blue Spade has used the creature as an excuse to attack people, to be more vicious. Ooh, vicious by Silver right there. And now, Going for it again. No, now take more damage. Take out the creature, but we're forcing it. Face, force. And now changing it up, putting the legs out. Oh no. Ooh, this is not gonna be pretty. Ooh! Kicking the head straight into the chair. Now, creature, looking for more weapons. Well, we saw some hardware we brought into a match earlier tonight. Now, creature, looking to do the same. Silver Bobby poking through the wall. Oh, rolling over. Oh, kick. Very sleek move. From one of the fastest. The most high flying wrestling beauty hits the ooh, creature using the strength though to stomp himself. Ooh, kick! Almost being broken through. Now gonna use our speed! Full speed ahead! Damage is done to the knee, but charging up for the Bronco Blast! Ooh. Undoubtable that got too hot. Creature back to the feet again. Ooh. Going for the pinfall. Silver ain't gonna give up that easily. The creature ain't gonna stop holding that easy. Ooh, stomping a mud hole into the chest. Ooh, again. Now make it three. Oh, frozen monkey flip straight onto the head. Goading the creature on. Ooh, kick straight to the jaw. Full speed ahead. Off the ropes now. Silver. Ooh, mounted using the full weight to take down the creature. Flying around. The fist drop. Would that be it? Not enough for the creature. I can see why Silver has been motivated though in this match. Dealing with this for about a year must be tiresome. Just remember, the former Black of Hearts, former BYU wrestler, former Solitaire member, had to deal with Walker's Mafia messing with him for several months. Same with Red Ace, same with Silver. Ooh! Silver using that chain, using anything to take out the creature. And if this was any regular man, I would say Silver would be doing absolute damage and would have won the match by now using some of these unique moves like this. But this is the creature. Creature feels the pain, and you know Bruce Bates gonna be black and blue tomorrow, not wanting to get out of bed. But this is a creature, he's gonna keep fighting, getting up. Ooh, despite being wrapped around his own throat, flip Silver over, and now going after Silver. Ooh, Silver submit. Silver's fighting, trying to grab the chair. Ooh, using it as a weapon now. Got the separation needed. Silver, chair in hand. Time to recover. Reloading now. And that's one of the things about Silver. No matter what, he's gonna keep fighting. As the match goes on. Flying with the chair!
Stay down!
Almost bending the damn chair over the creature's back! But the Silver have in mind. Getting the chair up now. DDT! Unique moves from Silver tonight! axe handle. Chael going into the gut of the creature. Lining up though. The still have in mind. Big kick. Got the creature locked now. Ooh, knee to the gut. Ooh! Oh, he's going for the parry kick into an ankle lock. Wait, what is the creature doing? Oh no. Using the chair for the ankle lock. Will Silva tap out? Creature could have just broken Silva's ankle. Look at the head of the chair. The head of the chair's mother has been ripped off. Creature having to bend it back in by stomping on it. No! Pyro driver onto the chair. Creature looks shocked. That's what I'm talking about. Creature broke the damn chair. Now using it for a unique weapon, doing big damage to the hand. That could cut your hand open. That's a sharp metal edge. Silver leaving the ring. Creature stalking Silver. Chair back in hand. Another weapon. Solid wood plank. High Silver wheeling now. Silver unable to stand. Wait, Spade. No, don't do the Spade. Pyro driver on the outside. Wait. No, that's a light tube. That's a damn light tube. Oh my god. Oh my god. No, put that down. Stop jabbing it into the back. That is your sibling, damn it. What the hell? Creature just walking on the broken glass. Finally! These two just fighting on broken glass. Look how stunned Silver's face is. Barely able to stand. Wait, no. That shot of glass in the damn hand. Wait. What does... No, using the ring bow. Straight into the head. Going for it again. Ringing the bell and ringing the head of Silver.
Are you
love having this to check to make sure the match can even continue.
Are you able to continue?
Silver might just have a damn concussion. Going for a suplex. Jabbing the broken right into the back. Creature feeling that one. Clearly angry, you see, holding the back. Silver might just rip the short using a broken light tube. Oh no. Oh my god! The creature is still standing! And now Silver's on the run! Silver doesn't know what to do! How the fuck is the creature standing? You can always see the blood starting to come from the creature's back! welts on the back of both competitors. Silver's shark, the creature, eating the punishment, goes straight to the face. Shaking it off. Ooh, heavy shots! Big arm drag! Heavy shot with the chain! And now with this, the creature I have in mind, clothesline him with the chain! This is an absolute war! I didn't even start forgetting that this is for the damn world title! They are just absolutely killing each other! Jabbing light tubes into each other's back, breaking light tubes into each other's back, tire drivers all around, weapons galore! This is extreme mayhem! Oh! Cosmo to chair! Oh! Man! Damn a needle! More blood coming from the back of the creature. Silver barely able to stand. Silver though fighting. Going for the gummy stunner. Shades of the gummy bears. Oh, shades of black hearts. United DT from Red Ace. Blue Spade's own blue in the face. The spell from Cyclone, pulling off all the Solitaire hits here tonight, and now, final notice, that's all she wants. The first one to pin, the creature will be Silver. What? What? Did the creature kicked out?
Stay down.
I am stunned here tonight. Silver is stunned here tonight. If this was any other person, Silver would have won this match
ten times
over. Creature's not staying down. Oh, straight to the head. Look at the mark on the back of Spade.
Down. He's
somehow getting up. Ooh, straight to the head. Ooh.
I don't like doing this to you. So stay the fuck down.
He just barely up. Silver destroying the creature. Oh, you kidding me? This is unreal.
Underneath that is regular blue spade.
That's right. I know all that is regular blue spade. And it looks like Silver's gonna show. That is regular blue spade scissors in hand. Cutting the max. Trying to weaken the creature. Ripping off the max. Knee to the head. Ooh, another big kick. Silver may just have this one. Wait, no. The scissor in hand.
Are you alright?
Creature just stabbed. His own sibling!
Are you able to continue?
Silver barely able to breathe right now. Stabbed straight in the stomach. And I think the shoulder. The life being choked out of Silver! And now, using the rope, to do more damage. The creature tying you on the hill. And now, the head. Pulling at the hill, pulling at the neck. Hey, what's at the end? Is that a noose at the end of it? No, no, Spade, don't do this. Ooh! This is ruthless. This match is absolutely ruthless. I'm now tying Silver in place. I think Silver just realizing now they cannot move. If they move too far away, they're gonna pull that tiger. Now that's a solid wood straight to the neck. Now to the lower back. Right where the right tube was broken over. No. Back with the scissors. Trying to go and stab straight to the throat. Ooh, Silver finding him. Got the hand up in time and then kick the creature in the face. Creature's getting up there. Ooh, trying to fight with a noose around the neck. Now going to stab again. Ooh, big kick. Silver's out. Silver has a chance. Charging the scissors. Ooh, straight to the face. The Max continues to run through. Big clothesline. And again, trying to wrestle the scissors out of the hand. And now trying to cut more of the Max off of the creature. Trying to weaken the creature.
Underneath here is Wiggle.
Blue in the face! That is it after all this. There's no way Silver is kicking out! What? Silver just kicked out after all the punishment here tonight! After being stabbed! After light tube! Silver still is fighting! Maximum DDT! That is it! One, two! What? On God's green orb was in Silver's coffee this morning!
You're not the only Vegetarian one. But I'll need a special max in order to do it.
Doubled up that chain and hitting Silver again. Reverse the blow in the face! Silver's still in this! Oh, trying to flip creature over. Wheelbill slam! Back with the chain again. Around the throat and now trapping the arm, going for the cashew top trap. No one escapes. Can Silver find out somehow rolling up but still in the kaiju top trap? Silver fading, trying to go rolling up. Ooh, back in the death trap! Trying to warp, no! Silver finding! There is no warp race! Trying to punch the creature! Still, no escape, trying to warp! Again! Back into the death trap! There is no escape, tapping now!
Come on! Tap!
What a match. What a main event.
Your winner and still BYW champion, the creature, the Leaf Bird.
Placebo did what they said they would do. Put an end to the creature. Silver Fox Valium. Will kill you if you are the champion. Blue Spade.